Hey, what's going on, kings and queens? Happy New Year's. I hope everyone had a safe and blessed, wonderful celebration bringing in the new year. Oh my goodness, you guys. I'm so thankful and I'm so wonderful, blessed. But anyways, you guys, hi, my kings and my tiaras. Doing over here on House of Queens TV. My voice sounds a little raspy. Excuse me, you guys. I was up late this morning. But I had to bring this to y'all attention. If you guys go back 3 months ago on my video, I'm going to post it right here. Okay, y'all remember the state of Illinois had a non-attainable offense beginning January 1st, 2023. For these right here, aggravated burglary, aggravated DUI, aggravated fleeing, arson, burglary, drug induced homicide, intimidation, kidnapping, robbery, second degree murder, and threatening a police official. These right here considered to be in the state of Illinois a non-detainable offense. Which means you will not go to jail. Again, let me read this off to y'all again. The state of Illinois, I did this video, go back, I did it 3 months ago. Let me show you guys. Hold on. Where can I do that? Right here. 3 months ago, the purge is coming for the state of Illinois, 2023. So if y'all go back to my content 3 months ago and look this video up and watch it from beginning to end, where it explains what this means for the state of Illinois, a non-detainable offense. Aggravated burglary, aggravated DUI, aggravated fleeing, arson, burglary, drug-induced homicide, intimidation, kidnapping, robbery, second-degree murder, and threatening a official officer means it is non-detainable offenses. So you mean you can kidnap, you can intimidate, you can do a robbery, you can DUI, fleeing, you can burn someone's house or just anything. Drug-induced homicide. That mean you can take somebody's life, but if you was under the influence of a substance or controlled substance, even pills or whatever, you can do a second-degree murder. You can even threaten a police official. You can tell the police that you're going to take their life. You tell the police you're going to do anything to them. And you won't get charged for it in the state of Illinois. And y'all know, when I did this video, I was like, oh my goodness, this is freaking crazy. It's going to be Armageddon over there in the state of Illinois. So, okay, hold on, guys. It's open. So, you guys, so, that means I was saying it's going to be the Armageddon for the state of Illinois. So, we had an update. I actually forgot about it. My, the boyfriend had brought it up this morning. And so, I went to go look for it. And this is what I found. So, if you guys here for the first time, welcome, welcome, welcome. House of Queens TV. I am your girl, Queen 318, Rare Educated Diva. And you are tuning to who? You are tuning to what? You are tuning in to House of Queens, baby. If you're here for the first time, welcome, 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 welcome. Subscribe, 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 subscribe. Awesome. Hit that notification bell button. Thumbs up. And leave a comment in the comment section because I know you guys thought about this content. Let's get into it.
Well, this all started after a judge in a lower court in Northern Illinois announced that ruled that the cash bail part of the Safety Act is unconstitutional. State leaders like the governor and attorney general appealed the decision to the Illinois Supreme Court. The Illinois Supreme Court submitted a four-page document over the decision last night. The decision halting the elimination of cash bail until further notice. The court's ruling applies to the entire state, not just the 65 counties that had sued to stop the law, like here in Madison County. The Illinois Supreme Court sharing on Twitter, quote, "This is being done to maintain consistent pretrial procedures in Illinois until the court can hear the appeal, which will be heard on an expedited basis." The Illinois Safety, Accountability, Fairness, and Equity Today Act sought to change multiple parts of the Illinois justice system. According to the U.S. Commission on Civil Rights, the cash bail system disproportionately impacts Black and Brown communities and other underrepresented and impoverished groups who cannot afford bond. Kanakee County Circuit Judge Thomas Cunnington severed the cash bail provisions from the rest of the legislation on Wednesday. He did not argue against the portion of the law regarding...
Before I let y'all see the other part about the Illinois no bond thingy for 2023, let's hear about what Biden did. I think this is something good. I haven't did too much details about it, but right here where it says up here in the top, Biden pardons an 80-year-old woman convicted of taking out her husband when she was 33 years old. She is now 80. She went to jail when she was 33 for allegedly taking out her husband. He not only pardoned this woman, he had pardoned another guy. I think he was a Marine. He was sentenced to 4 months to a drug and alcohol program while he was on duty. This guy was under the influence of alcohol. I believe it was alcohol, but I'm going to say allegedly for alcohol and a controlled substance. He was carrying out his duties as a United States Marine. Do y'all understand that? He could have put a lot of lives in danger. You don't understand how difficult, I mean, saying this is, that man put a lot of lives in danger if they was possibly over to another third world country or whatever. But that man put a lot of lives. But anyways, he was pardoned, and four more other people was pardoned as well. He didn't go into specifics on what was the other people pardoned from, but the main two that I know of so far was this 80-year-old woman was pardoned for taking off her husband at the age of 33, and she's now 80 years old. And the young man who was put into a rehab program while he was on duty for 4 months. He was in the program for 4 months while he was under the influence of a controlled substance and alcohol, representing the United States of America. And Joe Biden had pardoned these individuals. So let's get into what he has to say.
President Biden has granted full pardons to six people, giving them a fresh new start in the new year. Each of the individuals had already completed the sentences for their offenses, which include drug-related crimes and second-degree murder. Biden pardoned an 80-year-old who was convicted for murdering her husband when she was 33. Another man who was court-martialed for consuming ecstasy and alcohol while serving in the military. After completing 4 months of confinement, he returned to duty and is still active.
Hello, I'm Mark Brown.
Yeah. I appreciate this brother for being a news anchor. I know it's not easy, the job that he has to do on a day-to-day basis. But, baby, who cut this brother's hair? Who cut this brother's hair? I'm not trying to, be funny, but yes, I am. Who cut this Negro's hair? Cha. But anyways, so this is another part of the Illinois Supreme Court put Safety Act on hold. Cash bail still in effect. So, these fools, they knew better. They knew. And I don't know who in their right mind. I'm going to have to say, some of a lot of Hughes sisters and brothers. I say a lot of Hughes. Now, I mean, when I say a lot of Hughes, we're talking about the white folk. Yeah, the white folk. So, who in their right freaking mind opposed this bill for the state of Illinois, one of the most dangerous states, not just the city of Chicago and Peoria and other little cities and towns there. I'm talking about for the whole state of Illinois. Who proposed this bill for the Safety Act, where you have all those offenses that I had explained to you guys in the beginning of this story? Go back and rewind it if you want to hear it again. That you have a non-cash bond. That means you can get out of jail, or you ain't gotta go to jail. Just go ahead, make a process, and assure us. Sign a piece of paper and assure us on your good faith of word. Just sign this piece of paper, and you give us your word that you will show up back here for court. Because we believe in the judicial system, that you sign this piece of paper and you giving us your word that you will show up back here for court. Because we're going to do this for you. We're not going to do a cash bond. You just sign this piece of paper and you assuring us that you're going to come back to court when it's time for you to go to court. Who the freak came in with that bill? But I'm so happy. I am so happy and I'm so glad that this is put on hold. They need to go ahead and eliminate this total and all, because this is absolutely unacceptable. But let's get into what this good old brother with this fucked up haircut got to say.
Court stopped it from taking effect tonight. The court issued an order staying the elimination of cash bail until further notice as it prepares to debate if the Safety Act provisions are constitutional this week. Kankakee County judge ruled the pretrial release provisions are unconstitutional, leaving cash bail in place in several counties that were part of the lawsuit. The state has appealed the ruling.
Yeah, because y'all know that shit was not cute at all. And shout out to this sister, also coming from Illinois, as a news anchor. Shout out to this sister as well as a news anchor. So she giving her opinion as well on the cash bond bill still in effect. And Illinois Safety Act is put on hold. Again, like I told you guys, I'm just giving y'all different people's opinions on the issue of this cash bill that I posted about 3 months ago. So again, go through my content. I might leave a link in it, the description box or in the comment section. I don't know. I doubt it. But like I said, I made a video about this 3 months ago. I showed y'all in here what it was. So go ahead and view that content so you can get everything. I might leave a little clip of it at the end of this, but I don't want to make the video too long and dry it out. So let's go.
Tony Johnson, we begin tonight with some breaking news. The Illinois Supreme Court says the new law, known as the Safety Act, will not go into effect tomorrow. The court has halted the law, which would eliminate cash bail in the state. Just days ago, an Illinois judge ruled parts of the law unconstitutional. The state then appealed that decision to the Illinois Supreme Court. Tonight, the court says it will put the law on hold.
Electronic monitoring has to be invited, limited to kidnapping, armed robbery, second-degree murder, drug-induced homicide, aggravated DUI, threatening a public official, and aggravated fleeing and eluding. Offenders released on electronic monitoring have to be in violation for 48 hours before law enforcement can act. They can almost drive to Alaska before we can even look for them. It denies victims their constitutional rights. And keep this in mind, businesses and homeowners. Officers will no longer be presence or your businesses. Someone could decide to live in your shed, and all we can do is give them a ticket. You have to decide what level of force is required to remove them and whether or not it's legal. This is a massive threat to the residents of Oil Park, Cook County, and Illinois.
Indeed it is.
All by the citizens are going to suffer because of this, but this is just par for the course when it comes to the Democrat agenda.
Step on someone else's content, but I'm giving my opinion.
Okay, you guys, so that is what I think he was a deputy officer that he was giving his opinion on the situation, which he was very disgusted by. And I know it made a lot of concerns for the people in the state of Illinois. Because like I said, this is one of the most dangerous states in, you know, on the map. So that raised a lot of concerns for not just the state of Illinois, for everyone else. I have a loved one in the state of Illinois, and I had, she wasn't even aware about this. She owns a few properties in Illinois and stuff like that, and so she wasn't even aware that this was going on. I had to call her and tell her to watch the video to tell her what's going on. You stay in the good old state of Illinois, girl, and you don't know what's going on out there, girl. Let me put you up on game, honey. Yes, ma'am. Let me tell you what's going on, what they're trying to do to you. They're trying to off y'all off, honey. Yes, ma'am. Stop. My cousin was very appreciative of me giving her the information. I was like, thank you, boo-boo. She was like, thank you, boo-boo. And I was like, you're welcome, honey. You're welcome, sugar. So, anyway, this wraps up what I have today for this my first video, y'all. My first video of 2023. I had to give y'all a recap and an update on what's supposed to happen for January 1st of 2023. I forgot about it. My boyfriend told me about it. But let me give y'all an update on it. So, thank y'all so much for just viewing my content. I hope you guys have a safe and wonderful, blessed day. Happy 2023. And let's get this up from here. House of Queens TV, baby. We locked in. Let's go. Let's get it. And this thing called life. Sometimes it's good. Sometimes it's bad. Put your faith in God. He will see you through. I love you. God love you. I hope you love yourself even more. Keep it in mind. It will get greater later. And if y'all been locked in with me from the beginning or whatever, I used to do this one thing like this. Bingo was his name. Oh, I don't know why I used to do that shit, but some people thought it was really, really cute, but it was more polished than that. I just thought about it 2 days ago, but I used to do that little thing. Go to my videos. I used to do that at the end of my videos, but some people want me to do it again. I don't know. I gotta go back and see how I did it, but they thought it was really cute. I don't know why I started doing that. What the B-I-N-G-O got a bingo? What the hell that got to do with anything on my content? Nothing. They thought it was cute. But anyways, you guys, just keep living your life the way that you see fit. Can't nobody live your life for you. You can't live your life for no one else. You have to live your life for you. Get it? You have to live your life for you. You're going to have good times. You're going to have bad times. But God always loves you. God always have your back. He's always going to be there for you when you think no one else is going to be there for you in a time of need. It may feel like you don't have nobody. But you can hit me up in my DMs. You can hit me up in my comment section. If you want to talk, I can reach out to you. And we can have a conversation. I won't judge you. Because some people do feel like they could talk to strangers before they can talk to their own family. And I'm here for you over here on House of Queens TV. I love everyone and everybody. I match your energy. But again, like I said, I love you, God. I love you. And I hope you love yourself even more.